My name is Zach Arnold. I'm a Hollywood film and television editor, a documentary director, father of two, and creator of Optimize Yourself. Since beginning my career, I have battled attention issues, anxiety, and creative burnout more times than I can keep track of. Back in 2005, after almost losing the battle with suicidal depression, I decided that I no longer wanted to sacrifice myself for the sake of my career. I was done barely surviving. I wanted to thrive. Since then, I have obsessively searched for every possible way to optimize my own creative performance. My journey is far from complete, but I have now made it my mission to shorten your learning curve so you can forge your own path to greatness without having to sacrifice balance in the process. Now it's time to start designing the optimized version of you. Hello, and welcome to a special episode of the Optimize Yourself podcast, where I provide my articles in audio form so you have the opportunity to listen instead of sit and read if that is your preference. My hope is that you're going to use this opportunity to get up and step away from your chair for the next 15 to 20 minutes and build the habit of moving more throughout your workday. Now, the following is a reading of my article titled, "There is a profound life lesson hidden behind this jaw-dropping photobomb. Can you find it?" Which can be found at optimizeyourself.me/photobomb. I hope that the ideas in this article inspire you to take action in your life. The reading will begin after a brief moment to recognize the sponsors that literally make this show possible for you. Thank you so much for your patience and support. This episode is made possible by ErgoDriven, the makers of the Topomat, my number one recommendation for anyone interested in moving more at their height-adjustable workstation. The Topomat is scientifically proven to help you move more throughout your day, which helps reduce discomfort and also increase your focus and productivity. To learn more, visit optimizeyourself.me/topo. That's T-O-P-O. Here are two things that rarely ever happen. Number one, me spending more than 5 minutes per day on Twitter. And number two, Twitter providing profound and meaningful value that's powerful enough to change somebody's perspective on life as they know it. But the perfect storm happened recently when I discovered this story while killing a few minutes on Twitter before a client session. Get this. Apparently, a married couple in China was going through old photos of themselves as teenagers, and they stumbled upon similar photos where each of them was standing in front of the same monument 20 years before. Cool coincidence, right? Well, here's where it gets interesting. The husband photobombed his wife in the background of her picture without either of them realizing it. They took the exact same picture at the exact same moment in time. Your mind still isn't blown yet? The husband photobombed his wife's picture years before they ever met. The same location, at the same single second in time, in a country with over 1 billion people. And this was before digital photography, no less. Now, I'm not a mathematician or a quantum physicist, but I would guess that the sheer probability of this has got to be around, I don't know, like 0%. Yet it happened. And not only did it happen, but there's documented proof. The what isn't as important as the why. This story quickly went viral with many news organizations and websites sharing it. But as far as I can find, everyone has focused on what happened and how amazing this coincidence is. But I have yet to find a story about why this is so important. Now, realizing there are certain things that happen in life beyond our ability to comprehend got me thinking about the life lessons that one could take from a seemingly impossible occurrence such as this. I reached out to my readers and listeners to see how the story impacted them. For me, this is a great reminder that life will always guide us where we need to be. So why stress? I've had a few instances where if I've missed an opportunity that was meant to be, it appeared for me again later, just like it did for them. True grace. And this is from Julie F. It seemed like this story and the photo proves the old saying that there are no insignificant moments. And that was thanks to Robert G. Amazing indeed. Just what I needed because I'm about to give up on ever finding a job. Lesson to be taken, don't ever give up. And that was from Christine S. No matter your religious or your spiritual beliefs, it's hard to question that these photos affirm something that we cannot quite comprehend is most likely guiding us in some way, shape, or form. And I too agree that there's no such thing as insignificant moments, only moments that we choose to ignore. And plus, thanks largely in part to Christopher Rush, never give up is a mantra that I live by every single day. But I think that there's another lesson in this story that anyone can apply to their own lives that will lead to success no matter the goal that they are pursuing. What this couple didn't realize until 20 years later is that at this very moment, they were writing day one of their origin story. The power of perspective. While there's no way to know what was actually going through the minds of these two young adults while taking these pictures, let's speculate for a second and let's just make up our own story. Let's assume that the young man in the photo was frustrated and depressed because he's still single no matter how hard he looks for a soulmate. He's miserable that he's making no progress and he can't see the finish line, especially given that he was sure he would have found somebody by now. And even worse, he doesn't believe that there's a path he can follow and he has no feeling of control. Therefore, he's chosen to give up on finding true love. It just doesn't exist. The young man is focused on the destination, and because he hasn't reached it yet, he has labeled himself a failure. Let's assume that the young woman in the photo was also single and looking for her soulmate, but her perspective is different. She truly believes that her soulmate is out there and the time will come when they meet. So she continues to live her life with joy and purpose and embrace the struggle, knowing that the day will come when she finds her soulmate. She continues to put herself out there even when the people that she meets along the way aren't the right fit. The young woman is focused on the process, and she is willing to embrace the struggle along the way, confident that her actions are leading her closer to the finish line. Same picture, yet two very different perspectives. So what the heck does a 20-year-old photobomb in China have to do with you? Well, there is a good chance that you are approaching the most meaningful goals in your life the same way that the young man in the photo was. Having spoken one-on-one with hundreds of people in creative professions similar to mine, the overarching theme is the frustration that there is no single path to follow that will lead to success. Not knowing whether or not your actions are leading you forwards causes stress, anxiety, and ultimately causes many people to simply give up because they are seemingly getting nowhere. While taking nothing away from the difficult accomplishment that is becoming a doctor or a lawyer, they have a very clear path to follow with benchmarks along the way. But in creative professions, it's conceivable that you can spend over $100,000 on your education and also spend years doing additional training and working unpaid internships only to end up fetching a director's coffee and dry cleaning for the next 10 years. I spent the first decade of my film editing career jumping between random indie trailers, featurettes, short documentaries, as well as editing several low-budget indie films that I would prefer not to have on my IMDb page. If I had to choose a single word to describe the first 10 years of my career, it would be scattershot. Had I set the goal, I will be a successful A-list editor working in scripted dramatic television by age 29, I would have woken up on my 29th birthday as a massive failure. My only choice that morning would have been to turn around with my shoulders shrugged, my tail tucked between my legs, and become an accountant because that would be the reliable choice. Yet less than a year later, I landed my dream job editing the television show Burn Notice because I focused on the process and I had clarity about the destination that I was working towards. I took action consistently and I embraced the struggle along the way, confident that my consistent actions would lead me to the right opportunity eventually. Change your vocabulary, change your life. You will no doubt call me a liar, but I affirm the following statement to be 100% true. I don't have any problems in my life. Not one single solitary problem. So how in the world is this possible? My life is far from perfect, and I struggle every single day to balance a demanding job as a television editor, a documentary director, a blogger and podcaster, a father of two highly energetic and creative kids, being present for my wife, as well as building multiple online education programs, both for my own business as well as for LinkedIn Learning. The reason that I don't have problems in my life is simply because the word problem isn't a part of my vocabulary. My life is instead full of challenges and obstacles. When I'm faced with challenges and obstacles in my life, I know that there are only two possible outcomes. Number one, I will overcome my challenges and obstacles and succeed. Or number two, I will fail, learn from the experience by understanding why I failed, and then I will continue forging ahead. No matter the obstacle or challenge that I'm facing at the time, and no matter how many times I fail, I'm always thinking one thing. When I succeed, this is going to make a great story. Be willing to embrace the many challenges and obstacles in your life as learning opportunities. The more that you fail, the faster you're learning. And the faster you learn, the closer you are to success. Moreover, it's okay if your roadmap to success is fuzzy right now. Just make sure that your picture of the destination is crystal clear. And most importantly, be okay with the uncertainty of not knowing exactly what the path to success looks like, because the next important action that you are about to take is just another chapter of your origin story. Who knows? Maybe 20 years from now, you're going to be working with the next Steven Spielberg, or maybe you'll even be the next Steven Spielberg, and you'll realize that you photobombed Spielberg himself while you were getting coffee for his assistant's assistant. Now, if you're interested in learning how to design your own unique roadmap to success, I would love to work with you in the first round of my brand new Design Yourself program. If you'd like to learn more, just go ahead and visit optimizeyourself.me/design. I hope you enjoyed the reading of my article titled, "There is a Profound Life Lesson Hidden Behind This Jaw-Dropping Photobomb. Can You Find It?" which can be found at optimizeyourself.me/photobomb. I hope that you were inspired to take action in your life and it gave you the opportunity to step away from your desk and incorporate just a little bit of movement into your day. Thank you for listening. Be well. This episode of the Optimize Yourself podcast was made possible by Ergo Driven, the makers of the Topo Mat and Topo Mini, my number one recommendations for anyone interested in moving more at their height adjustable workstation. Listen, standing desks are only great if you're standing well. Otherwise, you're constantly fighting fatigue and chronic pain. Not like any other anti-fatigue mat, the Topo is scientifically proven to help you move more throughout the day, which helps reduce discomfort and also increase your focus and productivity. My friends at Ergo Driven did extensive testing and compared their product to the top-of-the-line floor mats, and they found the Topo drove almost 2.5 more moves per minute with 270% more foot motion. Now, what this simply means is that the Topo users move more. I'm standing on one as I read this, and I don't go to a single job without it. And if you're smaller and you're concerned the Topo mat is too big, or you simply don't have the floor space, there's a Topo Mini for that. To learn more, visit optimizeyourself.me/topo. That's T-O-P-O.